If you have read CockroachDB docs or seen our tech talks, you must have seen this architecture diagram or this one, and you must have seen these terms floating around. But what do they mean? Let's try to piece them together. To start with, consider CockroachDB as a single node black box. Then you can treat CockroachDB as the quintessential SQL database. That means you can connect your app or SQL client to CockroachDB and do normal SQL stuff with it, like create databases or create tables or perform CRUD operations. Now let's look under the hood and zoom in a bit. The node that the app or the client connects to is called the gateway node. And the machine that the CockroachDB node runs on has characteristics like CPU, memory, and number of cores. Under the hood, CockroachDB is in fact a key value store, and the key value store we use is RocksDB. Now back to the SQL stuff. The layer that your app connects to is the SQL layer. This layer creates logical and physical plans which it sends to the transaction and distribution layers. The distribution layer maps the SQL statements into key value pairs in the form of 64 megabyte chunks of data called ranges, and writes it to the disk. Along with data ranges, we also have system ranges, which are essential to CockroachDB's functioning. If CockroachDB was a single node database, this video would probably end here. But the power of CockroachDB lies in being a distributed database. So let's add more nodes to our cluster. But how many nodes do we need? To ensure consistency, CockroachDB uses a consensus protocol that requires a quorum on any changes to a range before those changes are committed. Because 3 is the smallest number that can achieve quorum, CockroachDB requires 3 nodes. The consensus protocol we use is called Raft. You can learn more about Raft in this excellent interactive overview of Raft. You can find the link in the description box below. CockroachDB distributes your data among your nodes and replicates each range to at least 3 nodes. The number of failures that can be tolerated is equal to replication factor minus 1 by 2. For example, with a replication factor of 3, 1 node failure can be tolerated. In that case, the ranges are under-replicated but still available. Now, if one more node goes down, then the quorum is not met and the ranges become unavailable. The final feature to understand is geo distribution. You can have all your nodes in the same location or in different locations, and the way to do that is by defining the localities of the nodes, and that is what causes network latency to come into the picture. So there you have it, the key terms and concepts of CockroachDB. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching.